I'm Gregory Fedora, and this is Monster Monday. This week, we are looking into Hogzilla, or King Hog, or the Bacon Bigfoot. What exactly is that? Well, it is a giant boar weighing between 800 to 1,000 pounds and is roughly between 8 to 12 feet in length. The indigenous people of Florida and Georgia told tales of these enormous beasts, and they hunted them because they were very, very valuable in their eyes. And their teeth were very precious to them. They would take them and turn them into necklaces or talismans. They thought that by killing the creature and taking its teeth, they would be able to get the same powers as the creature. It was almost like godlike things that they thought that once they had these powers, they could then go on to hunt bigger and better things. When the settlers came from Europe and other countries, they heard about these creatures and they too sought them because it was a prize. You know, they're hunters and hunters like prizes like that, it's large game. But they were unable to find them and they thought it was just more tales from the Indians. The shamans thought that perhaps the white man coming from Europe and these other countries just were not keen enough to see or hunt the creatures. They considered them magical. And thus, Hogzilla became legendary, mythical, cryptic. People just thought it wasn't real. And as time went on, other hunters in the 1900s and so would talk about this mysterious boar that they saw, but it was like the big fish that always got away. No one was able to catch it. It was just another folklore, another story they talked around the campfire about. Like, I saw the Hogzilla, I saw King Hog, I saw Bacon Bigfoot. But then in 2004, someone did not only see it, but shot and killed it. A hunting guide by the name of Chris Griffin, and not the Chris Griffin from Family Guy, killed Hogzilla. After killing the creature, Chris took a photo of it and he posted it online. This photo went viral because it showed an enormous hog, well over 8 feet and over 800 pounds. This photo caught the attention of a prestigious organization known as National Geographic. National Geographic sent a team that included a pig geneticist, a wildlife ecologist, and a pig behavioral specialist. And they determined it was real. But not only was it real, it was a hybrid between a wild boar and a domesticated pig. Now, love is love, so I guess the domesticated pig found the wild boar attractive. You know, he's a scamp out in the woods. He wasn't like the other domestic pigs wallowing around in the mud. This guy was a stud going through the mountains in the woods, and so she said, that's a pretty handsome boar over there. So they had a baby. That was Hogzilla. National Geographic was unsure how this thing could have existed, and they are still unsure to this day. The other thing they're unsure of is if there was just one of these, there has to be more, because pigs usually have between 3 to 6 in a litter. So that means there's possibly 5 more Hogzillas in existence in the woods of Georgia and Florida that are out there running free. Now, when you're out hiking in the woods of Georgia and Florida, be careful, for the bacon you seek to eat might be seeking to eat you. As always, stay safe and keep searching.